In line with the presidential directive, the Directorate of Public Prosecutions has directed the Criminal Investigations Directorate, working jointly with the State House Anti-Corruption Court, to expeditiously conduct a criminal investigation into the allegations of theft of iron sheets that were meant for vulnerable people in Karamoja. Police spokesperson Fred Enanga and the DPP spokesperson Jacqueline Okui confirmed the development, saying these will be prosecution-led inquiries.
The task is going to be handled by a joint team that comprises officers from the office of the DPP, the Directorate of CID, and the State House Anti-Corruption Unit. We expect this team to expand on the preliminary inquiries that have so far been conducted and also further liaise with sister agencies like the Office of the Inspectorate of Government and even the parliamentary team that is investigating the same.
Enanga noted that the task force will conduct subsequent interviews and record statements of all government officials, including the ministers who are cited in the iron sheet saga.
We are going to interact with all concerned personalities to ensure an expeditious investigation. Now, the directive further demonstrates the commitment of government to fight corruption in our country, and now that we have a task force in place, we shall be giving progressive updates to members of the public as we proceed.
Also, five former employees of the Uganda Printing and Publishing Corporation are set to be arraigned in court over mismanagement and embezzlement of public funds totaling 2.62 billion shillings. The five include Professor Waswa Tom Davis, the former managing director of Uganda Printing and Publishing Corporations; Kasekende Mujuzi, the former finance and administration manager; Kigonya Peter; Ahimbisibwe John Baptist; and Ayebare Catherine.
During the financial years 2019-2020 and then 2020-21, the Uganda Printing and Publishing Corporation entered into three contracts with the Electoral Commission. As a result, the Electoral Commission transferred to the Uganda Printing and Publishing Corporation an estimated sum of funds totaling 15,153,030,709 shillings, out of which an estimated 2,261,000,000 was allegedly embezzled.
Meanwhile, from the Ministry of Internal Affairs, three foreigners and one Ugandan are in detention for fraudulently obtaining Ugandan passports. They were today paraded at the police. Another suspect is a Nigerian national identified as Saudas David Joshua.
We recovered a Nigerian passport. You see how he has covered it? But this is a Nigerian passport. Let me remove it from this. This is a Nigerian passport for this gentleman, Saudas David Joshua. But now he had changed his name to Damba. Damba David Joshua to fraudulently depict himself as a Muganda from the Mamba clan. So our very keen officers looked at him and realized that he was telling lies.
Also, the National Promoters Association has issued new guidelines for all promoters organizing music concerts and events.
The National Promoters Association, which is called NPA, is pleased to announce that effective Monday 13th, 2023, all promoters organizing events in the country shall have to first acquire a letter of clearance from NPA. The NPA is committed to ensuring that promoters are comply with the new development, irrespective of whatsoever association you are affiliated to.
Report by Rachel Nachiwala for the news.